In this video, let's look at the architecture of Hadoop's distributed storage system. HDFS is architected as a master-slave system. The master system is called as NameNode, and it looks after or maintains the namespace of the distributed file system. Namespace is nothing but the entire catalog of files. What files are located where on the system, their sizes, blocks, replication, owners, and other metadata. You also have the slave services, which are called as data nodes, which look after the storage of the data. The NameNode master service will be typically run on a dedicated computer in the cluster, or a pair of computers where high availability is required. Master node generally has more RAM as compared with other data nodes in the cluster. Data node service runs on each dedicated worker node, that is each node for which is dedicated for the storage and processing. Depending on the size of the data and the processing time and the use case, the cluster sizes will vary from a single node to hundreds or even thousands of nodes. NameNode is the master service for the entire cluster. It doesn't store any data on itself, and it also doesn't handle any data either. It just manages the data on all the data nodes and rebalances the data from time to time. NameNode manages a catalog which is called as namespace. This namespace holds the information of what files are stored, what blocks are stored on which data node, and also maintains the file system details like file names, directory names, access details, file sizes, and various other metadata. Whenever the data need to be read from the cluster, the client application will ask the NameNode for the details of a certain file, and the NameNode will inform the client where the data blocks of a certain file can be found. Then the client application directly goes to the specific data node to read the data blocks. Data nodes deals with storage of data blocks on the local disks on a given computer or a node. The data on each data node might not be a complete file, and the data node has no concept of file names or directories. Remember that a data node only works in blocks, where typical block sizes are 128 MB in size. NameNode never touches the data, so it doesn't become a bottleneck during the read or write process of the data blocks. The client application writes to multiple data nodes at the same time and is not limited by the write speed limit of any single hard disk. During the write process, the data node automatically manages the replication of each such block to other data nodes. The process by which a client application writes to a Hadoop system is shown here. First, the client contacts the NameNode and asks where to write a particular file. Then the NameNode replies to the client with a list of data nodes, and the client application will send the blocks of data to the individual data nodes directly. And again, this is done in parallel. The data node themselves automatically handles the storage and replication of each such blocks to the other data nodes. Once the data is written from the client program, the information is only updated with the data nodes, and the NameNode doesn't have an information of where the blocks are written. So the next time when each of the data nodes send a ping or a heartbeat to the master node, in every 10th heartbeat, each data node will also send a report of all the data nodes of all the blocks that are available with each of them. That is when the master or the NameNode will update its own catalog or the namespace with the new data blocks which are written. Let's look at how the read happens from the cluster. If a client application wants to read data from HDFS, the client will have to contact the NameNode, which replies back with a list of data nodes containing the data. As discussed before, the NameNode never touches the data, so it doesn't become a bottleneck during the read process as well, so there's no impact on the performance. The client application will read from the multiple data nodes at the same time and is not limited by the read speed limits of any single hard disk. So here, let's look at the differences between parallel read performance and a sequential read with an example. So here we assume that we have one node in the cluster which has two input output channels and Each channel can handle 100 MB per second. And we want to read 1 terabyte of file from the system. Assuming a typical disk speed, read speed is 100 megabytes per second, reading this file from all the disks into the memory on this node can be done in around 45 minutes in a sequential manner. But if you want to read the same 1 terabyte file from a cluster of 10 nodes, the cluster will take around 4.5 minutes to read the same 1 terabyte of file. So reading a block divided file in parallel into the memory of each machine in the cluster is going to provide significant performance improvements compared to the traditional storage methods which are being used. In the next video, we will have a quick understanding or overview of the MapReduce framework. And if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to the channel for more upcoming videos.